Carolina Journal Radio is a project of the John Locke Foundation. So who was this John Locke fellow? A 17th century British philosopher, a major influence on the American founders. And our next guest emphasizes another important aspect of John Locke. Duke University professor Michael Munger recently addressed the John Locke Foundation. His presentation focused on the following question. Was John Locke the first modern economist? Thanks for joining us.
It's a pleasure to be here. And the qualified answer is yes. Yes, he was the first modern economist. And 100 years before Adam Smith.
You take a look at this by examining a piece of John Locke's writing that's not one of the ones that even the Locke experts spend a lot of time on.
It's almost unknown, and it was suggested to me by a friend who said you might want to look at this because she knew I was interested in the question of price gouging and whether prices were just, and she was absolutely right. The piece is called Venditio. And it's available, it was available just as a handwritten little piece of foolscap. It was found in 1691, and it's still available. In fact, I distributed handwritten copies, literal photocopies of the handwritten version of it in my talk here at the Locke Foundation. It's only 4 pages long, and the question that Venditio poses is the market price just? That is, are you justified in charging the market price? Would a good person charge or buy at the market price, or should you do something else? And Locke's answer is fascinating because he intuits what modern microeconomics took until the 1950s to more or less prove. If there's many buyers and many sellers and the product is homogeneous, yes, the market price is always just. The question is, what happens when you don't have a well-developed market like that? And then he adds to this, is only in 4 pages, just in 4 pages, he adds to that an ethical theory that we're kind of still wrestling with. And, you know, he probably wrote it in some late afternoon when it's dark and rainy outside because he lived in England.
And this was when he was not thinking about how you should run a government and other things. Well, on the side, let's invent a modern economics.
About the nature of epistemology, about the nature of contracts. He was really a remarkable guy.
When you first came across this publication after it was recommended to you, were you surprised that you had never heard that Locke had these insights before?
I considered myself to be something of a scholar of Locke. So not only was I surprised that I hadn't, I was convinced that this was something that the discipline needed, that political science and economics needed it. So 2 years ago, I published from Oxford University Press an anthology in PPE, and we added this. So now it's actually available in print. There aren't many places it's available in print, but the Oxford PPE anthology contains the Venditio.
We are speaking with Professor Michael Munger of Duke University on this question of whether John Locke was the first modern economist. When you read this 4-page piece, does he capture things correctly, or like in other areas of Locke's writing, are there some things that he doesn't quite get right that need a little bit more fleshing out?
Well, it's only 4 pages, but to be fair, and maybe there's an error, there's a little bit of anachronism. That is, I'm using my knowledge of modern microeconomics to fill in the gaps between what he says. But much of what he says about price is right. The reason that we need price, and we're talking about this in the literal shadow of the flooding in Texas, and I've heard the Texas Attorney General saying that he's going to enforce anti-gouging laws. Well, the question is, what does price actually do for us? Very few people are educated enough about economics. I think this is catastrophic. Very few people know enough about economics to recognize how important price is. And Locke clearly understood that. He understood secondary markets. He understood the role of price in signaling where resources and assets should be sent. That's pretty amazing.
John Locke wrote in the 17th century. We're in the 21st century. Why is it that insights that he had that long ago are still up for debate now and people don't get them?
They were controversial then. I don't think he persuaded anyone. And what I find so fascinating about it is that the Venditio actually contains 4 examples that he uses to illustrate his points. So it's really useful pedagogically. It's not really a theoretical piece, but it's a good thing for teaching because you ask these questions that he asks and then use them for students' discussion. And I've often had people say, after hearing this, I've actually changed my mind about price gouging laws. I understand why some people might favor them, but price gouging laws are probably a bad idea. Almost no one believes that. We do a bad job at economic education in high school and in college.
If John Locke came up with these insights that long ago, when did we really see other more known economic scholars come to these same conclusions or at least tackle these same issues?
In some ways, David Hume did in the 18th century. Certainly, Smith did in the 18th century. But I would say Alfred Marshall in the very end of the 19th century was really the first to recognize the importance of the role of price in allocating resources. And since then, we tend to have problems with this theory of price because we think, well, it's not fair. Well, a lot of things aren't fair. The question is, what's the best that we can do in difficult circumstances? And price should work for us, not against us.
You mentioned that this venditio is very helpful pedagogically in the classroom. Is it the type of thing that you'd like to see more economics instructors employ? Does it help students actually have that aha moment?
I think it does, and I think it's something that's really appropriate for high school. And it's actually available a couple of places online now. So if you're interested in using it in a high school class or a college class, if you just Google Venditio, you can easily find it online. It's easily available. I, of course, think that it's useful as part of the book that I publish, but I hope that people will. I've also tried to publish some explications, some ways of teaching it. So I'd be happy to try to share those. The nice thing about it is it doesn't really reach many conclusions itself. It poses these questions, and then students can explore what they think are the ethical and practical issues of trying to implement a system where we use price to allocate resources.
It sounds as if this is another way in which John Locke can really prove valuable to people today. I mean, we see him as valuable in sharing some of the ideas about freedom and limited government and serving the governed.
Well, and his letter on toleration.
Right.
It's really the breadth of his interests is amazing. When you add this economic work and his work on money, you could basically have a college curriculum just looking at Locke's work and its extensions.
When you do use this piece, you mentioned that there are some people who actually do change their minds about price gouging. Do you hope that that continues to be true, that other people will employ this same tool and tell people, what you think about price gouging isn't what is actually so?
Well, price gouging is a bad thing. Cutting people open with a sharp piece of metal is a bad thing. But if they have appendicitis, you may need to do it. So high prices after an emergency are a way of signaling other people what we most need. So I'm not advocating price gouging. What I'm saying is that allowing price to do its work can be of great help in an emergency because the state is not very good at bringing these things in.